Hello, I'm Bill Rao from MS Rao New Orleans, and next to me is the Sun King himself, Louis XIV. This sculpture is so important. In fact, it's considered the most famous sculpture that was made post the Renaissance. What makes it so spectacular? In the 1680s, France was the most powerful country in Europe, arguably the most powerful country in the world. And Louis XIV, the Sun King, wanted to show his power. So he commissioned from the most famous sculptor in France, Francois Girardon, to create a giant sculpture that would stand in the center of what is now Place Vendôme. And this wonderful sculpture was to be emblematic of the king's power. And this sculpture, of which this is a smaller version, of course, was eventually made in the 1680s, was unveiled. The sculpture was so big, it took 80,000 pounds of bronze to make. Put that in perspective, 80,000 pounds to create. It was bigger than any sculpture that had ever been made since the Renaissance, and it was by far the largest sculpture that had ever been made in France itself. So he creates a sculpture, and when it's unveiled, it's an instant hit. Virtually every other monarch sculpture, presidential sculpture throughout Europe and throughout the Americas for the next 150 years was somehow or another based off of this famed sculptor. But what made it so wonderful? Louis XIV, here he is. But what makes it special? First of all, he's riding bareback. Why is that important? Louis XIV commands everything. He doesn't need a saddle. He doesn't need a strong harness to control the horse. Everything is under his power. He's wearing a Roman toga. This reminds everybody of the ancient Caesars. He's the same as the Caesars. He's powerful. The only sign that it's French is the wonderful fleur-de-lis that are on the mat sitting below him that shows he's the King of France. Below him is a shield and a sword that the horse is trampling over. Why is that important? That's important because that shows that this was a vanquished enemy. On the other side of the statue, which you can't really see from your angle, the king's hand is pointing up with one finger saying, "I am France. This is my royal edict." He has this voluminous long wig that's just extraordinary and showing his vitality and his power. Everything about it was symbolic and emblematic of his power. So this gets unveiled and everybody loves it. And for the next 105 years, it's the sight to see in France. Unfortunately, his great-great-great-grandson, Louis XVI, eventually loses his head. And the statue, all the royal emblems were being taken down, and this wonderful sculpture that stood in the middle of the most famous Place Vendôme in Paris was taken down and melted down. Only one part of it remained, and I have his right foot, but I think it was his left foot that remained, from about here down, which is this big by itself. And that is on display in the Louvre, very prominently displayed in the Louvre, where anybody can go and see it. And that's the only part that remains of this original, wonderful sculpture that basically every major monarch and presidential sculpture was somehow or another influenced by for the next 150 to 200 years. Luckily, the artist made a couple of small examples. And a few more were made over the years. And so this is one of those wonderful examples. Ours was made around 1800, 1810, maybe as late as 1820, right around, right after Napoleon left power. And these examples, these smaller examples, one's in the Louvre, and one of them is in the Queen's collection at Windsor Castle, very prominently displayed as arguably the most important monarch in European history.